Hello everyone, welcome to the next lecture on the GATE mathematics. Today we will discuss about all those questions from the year 1996 to 2023 related to the continuity and differentiability. Myself, Dr. Harish Garg. You can simply follow my YouTube channel where you will find the playlist of the CSR UGC net. You can see the PY questions on the various topic wise. There is one more playlist called as the GATE mathematics where you can see the PY question of the wave equation of the GATE last 17 years as well as each topic wise previous year questions video. Also, you can see there is a PY question of the CSR net complete description and here. You can simply follow my YouTube channel Dr. Harish Garg. If you want to join my WhatsApp group for the more discussion and the doubt session, you can simply scan and join my this group. Now, first of all, what we will see in this lecture, we will see very shortcut tricks, how you can solve the problems related to the continuity, differentiability, direction derivatives, and many more are there with the help of the shortcut trick. That lecture is only available at my channel, Dr. Harish Garg. We will cover all those questions from the year 1996 to 2023, which is related to the GATE mathematics and GATE statistics here. We will cover more than 40 plus questions and definitely, as usual with the previous video, we will describe all with the help of shortcut trick. So you can see that at the end of this video, you will find a very beautiful shortcut tricks so that you can solve the problem in a very less time. So look at that. Firstly, I can quickly go through some tips for you and then I can start with this video. So for any of the function f of x comma y, this function is said to be the continuous if, number one is, if this limit is existence and unique. Make sure it is existence for all the path, whatever the path you can take. The path means either you can take the path is y is equal to mx, or you can take path is y is equal to mx square, or you can take the path is mx raised to power 1 by 3 or anything are there. So whatever the path you can take, the limit is always existence. Second way is, if the function is not continuous, then you can simply say it is not a differentiable. This is the first method. Second method is, you can simply change this into the polar coordinates. The polar coordinates are x is r cos theta and y is r sin theta. But if your point is not origin, then your coordinates are x naught plus r cos theta and y naught plus r sin theta. Then we can take the limit as x naught square plus y naught square. Again, if this limit exists and independent of theta, then you can say the function is continuous. Again, if, for example, if I say this limit will be my sine of 2 theta, fine. So clearly says for the different value of the theta, it has the different limit. It means limit is not unique. Then if it is not unique, it means it is not continuous and you can say it is not a differentiable. Second thing is how you can calculate the partial derivatives. So if you have the function of this, you can say if my function is this, then you can easily calculate the partial derivative by keeping y as a constant. But I always recommended you can use this proper definition by using the to calculate the partial derivative. Make sure, remember that if the partial derivative with respect to x or the partial derivative with respect to y is does not exist, if any one of them does not exist, it again implies the function is not differentiable. Fine. So whenever you want to check whether the function is differentiable or not, you need to firstly check the continuity. If function is continuous, then check out the partial derivative. If partial derivative exists, then you may say it's a differentiable or may not be. And otherwise, you can say if does not exist, then it is definitely not a differentiable function. Second concept that we will cover in this is the direction derivative. So I will tell you the two different methods. You have to find the direction derivative in the direction of the u cap. Remember, this is always by unit vector. Fine. How you can check the unit vector? You can take the modulus value. It must be 1. I will discuss the two different cases. First is f is differentiable. F is not differentiable. And what is the meaning of the not differentiable? It means it is not a continuous or any one of the partial derivative does not exist. If f is my differentiable, then you can easily find the direction derivative with the help of these shortcut tricks. What is the del f? Is called as the gradient. Fine. Gradient of the f and u is called as the unit vector. So unit vector is always given to you. Then gradient, if you are working on that xy plane, then you can return as here. If you are working on the z axis also, then you can return as z of k cap, and so on. Similarly, this is my u cap if you are working in the R3. If you are working on the R2, then this is more than enough. So make sure if you have to convert into the unit vector if it is not given. Otherwise, if the function is not differentiable, then it means you are unable to find the partial derivative in the exact manner. Then you have to apply this limit. That's a simple rule. If this limit exists, then you can say the direction derivative exists, otherwise not. The last concept for you, how you can check the function is differentiable at the point a comma b or at the point 0 comma 0. So as I told you, if the function is not continuous, then it is not differentiable. Fine. If either fx or fy, either one of them not exist, then again you can see the function is not differentiable. Fine. But if this is a continuous, this also exists, then it may be differentiable, it may not be. So for that you need to apply this definition: a plus h, b plus k, f of a b, capital A and capital B. If capital A and capital B are defined like here, if this exists and the unique, then you can say this is a differentiable, otherwise not. Again, if you consider the 0 comma 0, then I can substitute A and B as a 0 and 0. So these are the simple tips for you. Now based on this, we can start with these pre-PY questions of the gate examination. So look at that. Before solving the question, this is a 1998 question. Before solving the question, just try to understand the options. Look at that. If assume that A is my correct, assume, what is the meaning of that? If A, it means either of them is does not exist, it means the function is not differentiable. Fine. If A is correct, then automatically D will be cancelled out. Fine. Now, what is the meaning of that? Both a partial derivative exist. Then this may or may not be correct. Fine. Now that's a simple observation about this option. So now look at that. My target is to firstly find the partial derivative of this. So that's a very simple. I can start with this limit h approaches 0. I need to check at 0 comma 0. So this is h comma 0 and f of 0 comma 0. So what is that? What is the value of the h comma 0? You can see this is 0. Minus 0 0 is again 0. Divided by h is my 0. So f of x 0 is cancel out. Fine. F of x is, this means this is the existence, so this option is also cancel out. What is fy? We will take about the limit as k approaches 0. F of 0 comma k minus f of 0 comma 0 divided by k. Again the numerator is 0, divided by k, again its existence. So this is the correct option. How you can check whether the function is differentiable or not? We can start with this definition: h comma k minus f of this ah minus bk divided by root of h square plus k square. What is the a and b? This is my a, this is my b. What is the f? This is my root of h into k. Minus 0 0 is 0, a is my 0, a is my 0, b is my 0. So this is 0 minus 0 divided by h square plus k square. Now clearly says this limit is does not exist. Why? You can see limit h comma k approaches 0 comma 0. Does it existence? If you simply take the path is k is equal to mh. What is the numerator? Numerator is m h square. Denominator is root of h square plus m square h square. This is the modulus sign. So clearly say it is my root of mod m divided by here. So it's not unique. Is it unique? No. It means the function is not differentiable. Although it's a part B, if it is only one correct option, you can easily get the right answer as my C is the correct answer. Okay, define the function f. Let s be the collection of all those points x comma y such that f is continuous at the point. So look at that. When the function is a continuous, look at that, is whether the function is continuous or not. You can see what is the meaning of that. This means either x is 0 or y is 0. So if I just try to draw the graphical representation of this, what is the meaning of the x0? This is the line of the x0. This is the line of y is equal to 0. Fine. On these points, the value is my 1. And outside that, the value is my 2. So outside that, value is my 2. So what is the meaning of that? What is the meaning of the function is continuous? At which point? Function is continuous only at the point of xy is equal to 0. It means, what is the meaning of that? S is collection of all those R2, because the domain is R2. F is continuous, so it is not continuous. Collection of all those x which is 0 union y is equal to 0. Why? Because this is either x is equal to 0 or y is equal to 0. Fine. Now what is the meaning of that? You can see, firstly I can think about here, this means collection of all those points such that x is equal to 0 union collection of all those points such that y is equal to 0. What is the meaning of that? Is it closed or open? This is a closed set. Fine. Because this is the close, this is there. So what is that? This is a minus. So what is the meaning of that? What is the complement of the closed set? What is the complement of the closed set? This is the open set. It means R square. That's a complement. R square minus. So S is my open set. So S is my simply open set is here. Now look at this another one. Okay, firstly, I will tell you the three different methods for this problem. Fine. The first method I can tell you very simple shortcut quicks. So if you have the function of this category, x raised to power a, y raised to power b, x raised to power c plus y raised to power c, a, b, c, d, such that a, b, c, d all are my greater than 0. Then this function is said to be the continuous if and only if. Remember, this is one of the most important tips for you. A over C plus B over D is my greater than 1. Whenever this property holds, then you can say function is continuous. Look at that. What is the A? 1. B? 1. C? 2. D? 2. If I substitute here, it is 1 over 2 plus 1 over 2, which is not greater than 1. It means this function is not continuous. Fine. This is my first method. Fine. Now second method. How you can check the function is continuous or not? You can simply convert into the polar coordinates. We have to check the points 0, 0. So x is r cos theta, y is r sin theta. Fine. So if I substitute here, denominator will be r square. So the function will be 2r square cos theta and sin theta divided by r square, which is 2, which is nothing but sine of 2 theta. Then take limit r approaches 0 of f. What is that? It is again similar. So now it is not independent of theta. It means for the different value of theta you have the different answer. It means this is my not continuous. Fine. Again, you can see by using this or by using this you can get the same answer. Third method, you can simply take the path as y is equal to mx, then the limit of this will be 2 m x square divided by x square plus m square x square. So it is 2 m over 1 plus m square, which is not unique on m. Fine. Again, it means it is not continuous. Fine. So it means f is continuous, this option cancel, f is continuous, this option cancel. So I always recommended you can use this shortcut tricks. Make sure a, b, c, d always be strictly greater than 0. It is not equal to 0. Fine. Now then the rest of the option, whether the partial derivative exists or not. So how you can do that? That's again very simple. So I can start right for here. What is the partial derivative? You can start with the limit h approaches 0, h comma 0 and 0 comma 0. So this value will be 0. What is the h comma 0? This is 0. So 0 minus 0 is, so it is a 0. He said does not exist. So this option is cancelled. Correct option is my B. You can find the f by also. So limit h approaches 0, f of 0 comma h, f of 0 comma 0. So again it's a 0 minus 0 is 0. So it means f both are exist and a are equal to 0. If somebody asks you whether this is a differentiable or not, since the function is not continuous, it means it is not differentiable. Fine? So it means it does not, it is not differentiable. Okay, again, you can see whether the function is continuous or not. You can see a is my 1, b is my 1, c is 2, d is 2. If you compare them with here, you compare this with the help of here. So what is the a over c? 1 over 2, 1 over 2, which is not greater than 1. It means function is not continuous. It is not continuous, it implies not differentiable. So function is continuous, cancel. Now two options. Firstly, check whether fx exists or not. So you can simply start with the limit h approaches 0. So f of h comma 0, h comma 0 is a 0 minus 0 over h. So this is 0. So f dash exists, fine. Fy, again this is a 0 minus 0, again 0. So f exists this. So here the word is only, fine. So we have to check for the other case also. So what you can do, you can start with the any other case. Limit h approaches 0, a plus h comma b minus f of a comma b. Fine. So I can start with the numerator part only. What is the numerator part is a plus h of b divided by a plus h square minus ab over a plus a square plus b square. Fine. Now that's a very simple calculation. You can see if I open this bracket, it is ab. I can take ab as a common. So what is that? It is a plus h square minus 1 over a square plus b square. Fine. Plus hb over this part. Fine. Now if I divided this by h on the both side, so you can see this h will be cancelled out and it will give you a finite answer. Fine. Now look at that. If I take the LCM, so what will happen? This is ab over h. So if I take b square will be cancelled out, so it will be my a square and a plus h square. Now what is the numerator part? If I open this bracket, it will be minus h of 2a plus h into ab over h. You can see h will be cancelled out. Again, this will be the finite as h approaches goes to 0. So it means this will be finite answer. So since it is for the arbitrary a and b, so it means the partial derivative exists for every point on the here. So this is the right answer. This option is also correct, but if only is not mentioned. Fine. This is a one method. You can solve this question by another way also. Like, because they are talking about the every point, you can start with the say 1 comma 1. How you can check the partial derivative at 1 comma 1? So it is 1 plus h comma 1 and 1 comma 1. So if I substitute this value here, it will be 1 plus h, 1 plus h square plus 1 and 1 over 2. Divided by 1 by h. So clearly says if you take the limit, it will be my finite limit. Fine. So otherwise you can simply start with the any of the arbitrary. Okay, look at this one. A function is continuous. Okay, find the value of k so that the function is continuous. So what is the meaning of that? The function is continuous means limit exists for all path. Fine. That's the definition of the continuous. So what is domain is xy plane. Fine. So your point is here. It means whether you will take the path as y is equal to mx, whether you take the path as m square x raised power cube or any one of them, the function is continuous always. So what is the meaning of that? You can take the path of this x-axis or y-axis, is on you. If I take on this path, what is the value of the y? Y is equal to 0. So if I substitute here, what is the value of this limit? This is must be k for the continuous. What is the value of this when y is equal to 0? So it is my 0. So what is the answer of k? K is my 0 is the right answer. Or if you want to move on this side, then it will be x is my 0 on this path. So if you take x is equal to 0 in here, then what will happen? Again, the answer will be my 0. So it is a 0 for the continuous k must be 0. So there is no need to take the path and here. You can simply apply the definition of this continuous. What is the meaning of the continuous? It must exist for all the path. So you can, that's a very simple, within a 5 second, you can get your answer. Again, you can see function is defined on the R2 plane such that here, and this function is continuous and then so on. There are so many methods are there. Fine, there are so many methods. The first method is you can rationalize them. You can rationalize them and then take the limits and then you can get the C, but there is no need of that. I will tell you a very simple shortcut tricks again, because function is continuous. First of all, if you you can simply like my video if you understand my this. Otherwise, you can simply scan and join my WhatsApp group for more discussion part. Look at that. A function is continuous in each case. Fine. So it means again we can apply the same rule. If I take on the x-axis, what is the value of the y? Y is equal to 0. So it means if I substitute y is here, it will be my 4x square plus 64. Minus 8, it must be C as limit x approaches 0. Fine. Now how you can find the C? What is the limit of this? You can simply rationalize them if you want. If you rationalize them, what will happen? It is a 4x square, it is this plus 8 divided by 4x square plus 64 minus 64. This will be cancelled out. So what is the C? As x approaches 0, it will be 0 plus 64. So it is my 64 plus 8 is C. So 8 plus 8 is 16. So what is the right answer of this problem is 16 is my right answer. Fine. Or you may take along the y-axis, the path will be my x is equal to 0. So if you take path x is equal to 0 in this case, you will get again as 9y square upon 9. And here again, you will get the right answer as 16. There is no need to solve anything. You can simply think about the definition of the continuous. It exists for all the path. So that's a simple way. You can simply scan and join my WhatsApp group as well. I hope you can like my videos too. Now you have to think about the direction derivative. Fine. So as I mentioned you in the earlier, if the function is differentiable, fine, then you can simply use this formula. Now you can see this is my polynomial. Fine. Every polynomial function is a differentiable function. So I can simply use this. What is the gradient? So partial derivative of f with respect to x, partial derivative of f with respect to y. So what is the value of the partial derivative of x? It is a ky minus 3x square y minus y cube of I cap, plus partial derivative with respect to y is a kx minus x cube minus 3xy square of j cap. Now what is the point is given to you? What is the point is 1, 2. So what are the points of this? It is my 2k minus 6 minus 8 of I cap plus k minus 1 plus 4, 12 of j cap. This is my gradient of f. What is the u? Check whether is the unit vector. So what is the u is minus 1 over root 2 I cap minus 1 over 2 j cap. Clearly says this is my unit vector because the value of this is 1. So I can simply take the dot product of this with here. So what is that? It's a 2k minus 14 into minus 1 root 2 I can take as the LCM, k minus 13 of minus 1. It comes to be 15 by root 2. So what is the right answer of this? You can simply see it's my minus of 3k, it is my minus minus plus 27 is equal to 15. So what is that? K is equal to, you can check about the option, it's a 12 by 3, it's a 4 is my right answer of this problem. Fine. So whenever there is a differentiable function, you can simply use this shortcut tricks for here. Otherwise, there is one more way. Suppose the unit vector is given to you as here, j cap. Fine. Clearly say this is not unit vector because the value is not equal to 1. So you have to divide by the value of this. Then you have to take this as a u cap. See, another examples are there. We have discussed many more. Okay, function is continuous, not differentiable and here. So as I told you, there are several methods. Whenever there is a term of the x square plus y square, fine, you try to convert into the polar coordinates. So what are the polar coordinates form? It will be my sine x square, it is my r square sine square theta divided by x is r cos theta, and this will be my r. So what is that? It's a r sine of r sine square divided by cos. Fine. Now what is the limit? As r approaches to 0, if it is a finite and unique, then it's a continuous. Now you can see sine of this function is a bounded, it is always less than 1, then it goes to the 0 as r approaches 0. So what is the meaning of that? Function is continuous. So function is not continuous, cancel out. Function may not be a differentiable, or function direction derivative does not exist. So how you can check? Function is continuous. Can you say this is a differentiable? We can't say that right now, because if it is a differentiable, we can easily see about here. So how you can find the direction derivative? Because the rest of the part is direction derivative. So as I told you, a simple rule is f of the point will be 0, 0. So it is 0 plus ha, 0 plus hb minus f of a, h, this divided by h. And then check whether this limit exists or not. If this is the exist, then where a and b are my unit direction. So if I substitute here, what will happen? It is sine y square by x. What is the y square upon h is? H b square over a. Fine. Into x square plus y square. What is x square plus y square is? H times a square plus b square. What is f of 0, 0? It's a 0 divided by h. So this value will be cancelled. So what is the limit as h approaches 0? Sine of 0 is a 0, so it goes to the 0, which is a finite. So it means the direction derivative exists in all direction. What are the direction is? Ai cap plus bj cap, where a and b are here. So what is the direction derivative does not exist, cancel out. Direction derivative exists in all the direction is the here. Fine. But now you check whether it's a differentiable or not. What are the rules for the differentiability? If I simply check whether fy or fx, firstly we can check for the fy. What is that fy? Limit of 0, h, 0, 0 of this. So clearly says this value of here, it is sine of h square by 0 into h divided by h. So clearly says this does not exist. Fine. What is the meaning of that? If one of the partial derivative does not exist, it means f is not differentiable. So f is not differentiable, this option is also cancelled. F is not differentiable, so limit is the right answer, is my c is the correct answer. Okay, look at this another one. Find the direction derivative. You can see this is my differentiable function because it's a polynomial. Then you can find the gradient. Now it's a three dimension, so partial derivative with respect to x, partial derivative with respect to y, and partial derivative with respect to z. What is the axis? 2x I cap, 2y j cap, 2y cap, 8z k cap. So what is the point is? 510. So what is the point at 510? 10 minus of 2, 0. This is gradient. Now what is the u is? 3i cap over 5 minus 4 k cap over 5. Which is a unit vector? So find the gradient. That's a simple dot product. I of I, 30 upon 5. J is a 0. So minus 2 into 0 plus 0. The right answer is my 6 is the correct answer of this problem. Fine. This is the first method. Otherwise, there is one more method. There is one more method you can see. If I write, this is here. As I told you, direction derivative method this. Here the point is 0, 0, fine. But here the point is 5, 1, 1. So you can start with here, 5, direction is here. So this is my A, this is my C, B is my 0. So 5 plus H A, 1 plus H B, 0 plus H C, minus F of 5, 1, 0. Fine. So remember, what is the A? A is my 3/5, B is my 0, C is my -4/5. Now you can check also, you can substitute this value in the given function, and then you can take the limit again, you will get answer as 6. But there is no need to solve whenever the function is differentiable. You can simply use the gradient. Okay, fine, check firstly again. This is of the form x raised to power a, y raised to power b, x raised to power c and y raised to power d. So a is my 2, b is my 1, c is my 4, d is my 2. So a over c plus b over, so which is not greater than 1. It means this function is not, is the function is not continuous. If it is not continuous, it means it is not differentiable. If it is not differentiable, then you are unable to find the gradient. Then you can start with the direction derivative as limit h approaches 0, f of the point is 0, 0, direction is here. So this is my A, this is my B. So I can return as h A, h B, minus f of point is 0, 0 divided by h. So if I substitute this value in the given function, what is the h A and h B? It is my h square a square, h into b, h4, so h4 a4 plus h square, this is my 0 divided by h here. So you can see h cube, I can take as h cube cancel out, so numerator part is a square b, h cube it will be my h square a4, h cube is my b square. Now you can see the limit existence, h will be cancel out, it is my a square over b. Now you can take as a as here and b is this. So a square is 1/2, b is my 1/√2. So it's a √2/2, which is 1/√2 is the right. Fine. So if somebody asks you, is the function a differentiable? It's not a differentiable. It is also not a continuous function. Fine. If somebody wants to find the partial derivative of x, you can easily find that limit f of h, 0. F of 0 divided by h, h comma 0 is 0, so f of x is 0, f of y is also 0, fine, but the function is not differentiable. Always apply this rule, simplest way you can start with this directional derivative. Okay, look at this one. The temperature T is varies inversely proportional to the square of the distance. Fine, so I can remove this constant and a k. If the original value of the t at the point 0, 0, 1 is my √3, then the rate of change. Rate of change means this is called as the directional derivative in the direction of the qr. So firstly find the unit vector of qr. Position vector of r minus position vector of q. I have to return each thing for the explanation, but once you are in the examination, there is no need to write this thing. You can write it directly. What is the r minus q? It's a minus 1 I cap, minus 1 j cap, minus 1 k cap. It is not a unit vector, so I can write this into the unit vector. Minus 1, minus 1 j, minus 1 k divided by √3. Fine. Now the only thing is we have to check about the derivative. So what is that? R is x square plus y square plus z square. Fine. So I can simply take off this. What is that? It is k over minus 2/r³ into x over r. Fine. Similarly, find the partial derivative with respect to y, minus 2k/r³ into y over r, and so on. So what is the gradient? This into I cap, so r4 will be common, minus 2k/r4 is a common, so it is x I cap yj cap and zk cap. Fine. Now you can substitute this value. What is the value of k? I can use this value. At this point, what is the r? R is 1 by using this. So r square is 1. This is root 3. So k will be my root 3. Now you can substitute here. What is the dot product of this? It is my at the point of 1, 1, 2. So firstly, I can find the value at 1, 2, 2. So it's a minus k is root. What is the r4? So r square is 1 plus 1 plus 4. So it's a 6. It is my 36. It is I cap, j cap, 2k cap. Fine. Now you can take that dot product. So what will happen if you take that dot product? Root 3 will be cancelled, minus this, and then minus 1, minus 1, minus of 2. It is my 4. It is my plus 8 by 36. 4, 2, 4, 9. So the right answer is 2 over 9 is the right answer of this problem. Okay, next one is, take sigma is greater than 1, then which of the following is a continuous differentiability here? Okay, there are the two methods are there. Fine. First method, you all know this is called as the zeta function, and every zeta function is a uniform continuous. If it is a uniform continuous, it means this is a continuous function. Fine. Also, the zeta function is a differentiable continuous function. So it means it is also a differentiable continuous. Or you can say every zeta function is my Lipschitz continuous. Fine. What is the meaning of the Lipschitz continuous? It means this is my differentiable continuous. So if you not continuous, cancel out. It is also the differentiable, it's also cancelled. It is not continuously differentiable because it's a Lipschitz continuous. It is also a here. Fine. This is the first method. If you remember, this is a zeta function. Second method. If you look about the statement, there is a one unknown term called as the sigma, and answer is not dependent on the sigma. So you can take sigma is any number which is greater than of 1. I can simply take sigma is 2. So this is my 2. Fine. And whenever there is a series, look at that, this is my infinite series. How you can check the convergence of the infinite series? Fine. How you can check that? Because you have to check for the continuous. So as I told you in my last lecture, you can see about my uniform convergence lecture, which is available at here. Uniform convergence lecture, I already told you f is continuous on the closed interval a comma b. If f is open interval a comma b, then you have to only check the limit as x approaches a positive and limit x approaches b negative. Fine. If both exist, whether they are equal or not, that is no problem. If both exist, then the function is continuous. Now you can see again I can return this as 2 comma, so it's a open interval. What is the value of at infinity? You can see I can return this function as here n is greater than 1, so this number is always less than 1, so this value will goes to the 0 as x approaches infinity. So it means this is my finite number. So what is the meaning of that? This function is my continuously differentiable. So that's the simplest way you can think about it. Okay, look at this one. A function is defined as here, whether rational and here. You have to think about the differentiability. Very simple. You can find the differentiable here. It's a 2x and 2 when x is my rational, otherwise irrational. Now you can see when it will be differentiable, when the left limit and the right limits are same. So it is differentiable only when x is equal to 1. Fine. So it is differentiable exactly at the 1 point, and that point is my x is equal to 1. F is not differentiable at 1 point in here, but you can see at x equal to 1 is exactly 2 point, cancel out. F is every point, it is not possible. Why? You can see, if I consider any of the arbitrary point A, fine, say A is my rational. Fine, student. If I take A as a rational, what is the neighborhood of the A negative? a negative will contain my irrational numbers, and if you take the irrational numbers, what is the limit of this? It is my 2a minus 1. Also, if I take x approaches a positive, if I take x approaches a positive, a is my irrational, a positive will be my irrational. Fine. So what is the answer of this is 2a minus 1. Both are same, but what is the value of the f of a? F of a is rational is a square, and you can see 2a minus 1 is not always equal to the a square. What is the meaning of that? F is not, what is the definition of this? Continuous. F is not continuous. If f is not continuous, it means f is not differentiable. Fine, but it is differentiable only at the point x is equal to 1. So right answer is my a is the right answer. If in this case, if somebody asks you check about the continuity, so when it will be the continuous, when the limit of the x square and the limit of the 2x minus 1 are same. So what is the meaning of that? If I write this, it will be this value. It means this function is continuous again only at, what is the value of x is 1, only at x is equal to 1, and also differentiable at x is equal to 1. Okay, look at this one, check about the continuous, not continuous, differentiable, and here again, since it consists of the x square plus y square, so we can think about the polar coordinate. So what is the function of the polar coordinate is? It becomes my r square. So if I take the limit r approaches 0, it goes to the 0, which is a finite and unique. So what is the meaning of that? It means function is my continuous. So the first option is cancel out. Fine. Second option is correct. Check whether it's a differentiable or not. So again, we can easily prove that if I consider any of the points, say a, fine, a is my rational. Fine, then a is my rational, then you can see what is the limit of x approaches a minus of the f. A negative, every rational number, the neighborhood of the rational number consists of the irrational numbers. Fine, so what is the meaning of that? So limit x approaches a negative, this irrational number, this value is my 0, which is same as limit x approaches a positive of the f, because this is also irrational, but which is not equal to f of a. Why? Because a is my rational and the value is my non-zero. This is only 0 when a is my 0. So it means this function is continuous only at 0, 0. It means function is not continuous r square minus of 0, 0. It means the function is not differentiable at r square minus 0, 0. So the function is differentiable everywhere, but there are so many points the function is not differentiable. Fine. Now again, you can see whether the function is differentiable or not. You can easily prove that, because the function is, if how you can check the function is differentiable at 0, we can check about the definition of here. Function minus 0, 0 minus a times h and b times k divided by h square plus k square. So what is the partial derivative of x, f with respect to x? So clearly say it's my 2x. Fine. And the point is my 0, it's my 0. So a is my 0, b is my 0, f of 0, 0 is 0. So this is my h square plus k square divided by, so what is the limit of this? So clearly says this goes to the 0. Why? Because degree of numerator is greater than degree of denominator. Whenever degree of numerator is greater than of the degree of the denominator, then the limit will always goes to the 0. So it means it is a finite, so function is differentiable only at 0, 0 is the right answer, is the C is my correct. Okay, look at this another one. A function is continuous at which point? So very simple again. The one way is you can check about the limits. Fine. So, or you can see the function is continuous at the point say a, then limit of the a negative is same as that of the limit of a positive. So what is that? If I take a as any rational or irrational, so if I take a as my irrational, then a negative will be my here 2x square minus 1. A positive is again irrational, it is my again this value, and it must be equal to the f of a, so that is x of 4. So now I can solve this. X4 minus 2x square plus 1 is 0, it means x square minus 1 is 0. So what are the points are there? X is plus minus 1. It means this function is continuous only at the point of plus minus 1. Here is only at 1, which is not true because minus 1 is also there. So the right answer is my C, only is the right answer. You can also ask, if somebody asks you whether the point is differentiable, again you can see the function is only continuous at here. It means function is not continuous on the domain of R square minus 1 comma minus 1. What is the meaning of that? F is not differentiable on the R square minus 1 minus 1. So you have to check about the differentiability at 1 or minus 1. So you can find the differentiable of this. So it's a 4x cube, it's a 4x when x is rational, x is irrational. So again you can check about the, again you can start with here, you can equal them, you will get as x square minus 1 of this. So you can see the function is differentiable at 0, 1, minus 1. So that's a way of this. Okay, look at this another one. F is a continuous function such that this is there. You have to find the derivative of this. You are very simple. You can apply this Leibniz rule. What is that? If you take the derivative, integration and derivative will be cancelled out. So this value will be from 1 to 3. Remember, we have to find the derivative with respect to x. So you have to find the g dash of 0. So what is that? This is 0 plus of t. Fine? Because this is the limits of that t. Now what is that? This is f of 3 minus f of 1. F of 3 is given to 11 minus 5. 6 is the right answer. Okay, look at this another one. A function is given to you. A usual matrix are given to you. Fine? It's a usual matrix and the discrete matrix. Function is defined u as of this for all x in the real. You have to check function is continuous or not. It's a topology, it's a matrix space. How you can check about that? So very simple. If I consider any of the open set, fine. If I prove that the inverse image of this is also open, then you can say this mapping is my continuous. Fine, that's the definition of the continuous mapping. Now look at that. Firstly, think about the usual matrix. So D1, you can see on this D1, what is the D1 is usual matrix. What is the open set of this usual matrix? Yes, anybody knows that? The what is the open set of this in the usual matrix is collection of all those pairs of the x comma a comma b such that ab is in the real. Fine. And what about the d2? What is the d2 is my discrete matrix. What is the open set of the discrete matrix? That is my collection of all those singletons, collection of all those x such that x is in my real. That is a singleton. Fine, clear. Now F is defined to be here. So F is a mapping from D1 to D2. Fine. So let's see F is continuous, F inverse is continuous. So firstly, assume F is continuous. Fine. I assume that F is continuous and we have to take on the open set of this. And I consider this is my open set in D2. That is here. Then what is the answer of this? What is that? By the definition of this, what is the F inverse of X? Is again a X. So is it open in D1? Is it open D1? No, because open in D1 is the pair of all those X comma Y. So what is the meaning of that? F is not continuous. So this option cancel, this option cancel. Now look at that. Assume that F inverse is continuous. Fine. So what is the meaning of that? What is the F inverse mapping? F inverse is the mapping from D2 to D1. So I can choose the one open set in this case, D1, and then so take any U is the open set in D1. Fine. Then my target is to prove this is the mapping inverse image of U. If I prove this is open in D2, then we can say F inverse is a continuous. When it will be open? If I prove this will be my singleton. Fine. So what is the definition of this? Again, you can see this is a simple U, which is nothing but my open in D2. So therefore, F inverse is my continuous. So F inverse is a continuous, but F is not continuous is the right answer of the problem. Okay, now look at this another one, which is the gate 19. G is a mapping from R2 to air. Which of the following is subjective continuous here? Okay, e raised to power x cos y, e raised to power x sine. Fine. So think about the definition of the injective. What is the meaning of the injective is 1 to 1. So can you think about any of the two points x1, y1, x2, y2 so that image will be same? Very, very simple. We know that this is my periodic function. This is my periodic function. Fine. So if I consider any of the point here, say x, 0. Second point is, what is the period is 2 pi. Any value of the x, you can choose x is my 3, 0. You can choose x is from minus 4, 0 and anyone in the domain. So clearly says the value of the this g, value of this g are same. Why? Because cos of 0 is 0 and the value of the 2 pi is also same. So what is the meaning of that? They are not, they are same, but this value are not same. What is the meaning of that? They are not 1, 1. Fine. If they are not 1, 1, it means they are not injected. Okay, look at the subjective. What is the meaning of the subjective is onto. So it means you consider any point in here, check whether the pre-image existence or not. Again, look at that. It's a x square. Think about any of the one property of the x, e raised power x. Any property of the e raised power x. We all know e raised power x can never be zero. Fine. So what is the meaning of that? But in this domain, 0 and 0 belongs to this. Fine. So what is the meaning of that? There does not exist any x and y in this codomain such that this value will be my 0, 0. Fine. Because sine and cosine both can never be 0 at the same time. So it means this value and this value will never be 0. This value, if this is 0, then this will not be 0. So both value can never be 0 at the same time. It means it is not subject. Fine. Okay. Now look at the other two options. H is the continuous inverse mapping of the G. Continuous inverse mapping of the G. Defines in the some neighborhood of the A such that H is my this value, Jacobian of the H. Fine. How you can find the Jacobian of H? This is nothing but the Jacobian of the G. Fine. That is a Jacobian of the G. So how you can find the Jacobian of the G? Because we have a G point. So what is that? If I consider this is my F1, this is my F2, this is the G. So this is the partial derivative of F1 with respect to X, partial derivative of F1 with respect to Y, F2 with respect to X, F2 with respect to Y. So now you can substitute it. It is e raised to power x cos y, e raised to power x minus sin y. What is that? It's a e raised to power x sin y. It is a e raised to power x cos y. So what is the determinant of this? E raised to power 2x. Now, at which point they want to calculate? At the point h is 1 comma 1 at h 1 of pi by 3. But I have calculated at the point of g. So g is the inverse image of h. H is the continuous inverse of the g. So what is the meaning of that? So AB is my here. So can I say from this case A comma B is nothing but h inverse of 1 comma pi by 3? And what is the h inverse of this? It's a g. So this is g of 1 comma pi by 3. It's a A comma B. So I can substitute this value at x is 1 here. So what is the answer of Jacobian at the point g? It is my e square. So once the Jacobian is e square, this is my 1 over e square. So c is my right answer, b is my wrong answer. Okay, look at this another one. F is my continuous mapping function defined on this, such that the function is my greater than 0. Area bounded by fx over the domain 0 to b. So here is a function. Fine, this is a 0. This is say b. This is the area bounded by this. Is come to be 3 plus b square minus of this one. This is given to you. Fine. So now you can see this is 0 to b. I can return this function as of this also. Fine. So what is the meaning of that? If you correlate them, if you differentiate, what is the meaning of that? F of x, if you differentiate, it will be x over 3 plus x square. Fine. Is it correct? Is that differentiable? Now you have to find the value of f of 1. So 3 over 4. So it's a 3 over, sorry, x is 1. So it's a 1, 3 plus 1, 4, 1 by 2. So 1 by 2, that's a 0.5 is my right answer of the problem. Okay, now this is another category. There's a very, very interesting question out there. As you all know, if you are in my WhatsApp group, I already told you many times the shortcut tricks. You can solve this question within a 5 seconds. Remember, very beautiful tips for you is here. This is only available at my channel. If the function is continuous on the closed interval a comma 0 comma 1, only 0 comma 1, fine, then this limits here. Look at that. What is the fx is? Coefficient of the x raised to power n. So you can see this is my continuous function because every logarithm function is continuous on my closed interval 0 comma 1, fine. Now you can remember these tips. If I open this bracket n times, that's the first part, fine. If I open this bracket, that will be the second part. The second part will be 0. Now what is the answer of this? F of 1. So what is the f is here? So can you write the answer is this? See, how many seconds you needed to solve this problem? No need to solve this by parts and anything are here. That's the only shortcut tricks as I told you. If you remember in my previous all videos, I already told you the shortcut tricks here. Now again you can see the limits n approaches infinity, 0 to 1 again here. So what is the fn? I have to return this in the form of this function. Fine. So what is that? X raised to power n is separate, 1 n is separate. What is the fx? If you compare, it will be 2 x plus 1. Now clearly says this is my continuous function on the close interval 0 comma 1 because it is a well-defined function. So what is that? Now you have to take the limits. You can see again same rule, x raised power n fx n 0 to 1. So I can replace, what is the fnx? Fnx is here, n can be outside, xn fnx. What is the answer of this is f of 1. So what is the f of 1? 2 over 2. So right answer is 1. how many seconds you needed to solve such problems? Less than 5 seconds are there. I hope you can like my video. Again, similar question. Again, you can see this is GATE 2020, GATE 2018, GATE 2007 are here. Again, this is again of the form n x raised to power n fx. So what is the fx according to this is e raised to power x square, which is a continuous function on the closed interval 0, 1. Limit is there 0 to 1. So what is the right answer of this? It is nothing but f of 1. So what is the right answer of this? E raised to power 1. 2.718 is the right answer of this problem. Okay, a continuous function is given to be, which of the following is the 1, 1 and 1, 2? I think very simple. Why? Because you can see it's a x square. Whenever there is a function of the x square, it is not 1, 1. Fine? There are so many methods. For example, you can draw the graph of the x square. So what is the graph of the x square is? Here. Fine? So, in order to check whether it's a 1, 1 or not, you always draw the horizontal line. Okay? Draw the horizontal line. If it cuts only one point, if it cut only one point, then it is a 1, 1, otherwise not. But here you can see it cut it at the two points on the curve. What is the meaning of that? It is not 1, 1. Fine? Otherwise, you can see when x is minus 1, when x is plus 1, function values are same. Fine? X1 and x2 are same, but you can see x1 is not equal to x2. So it is not 1, 1. It is a 1, 1. Both cancel. Now, whether it's a onto or not, so you can see again, whenever there is a term of the x square, fine, you can clearly see is x square plus 1 will never be 0, but 0 is the part of this R. So it means there does not exist any x in this R, in this codomain, in this codomain, such that f of x will be my 0. Fine, it means this value will never be 0. It means it is not my onto as well. So it means neither the 1, 1 nor onto is my right answer. Okay, look at this GATE 2021. F is a differentiable function such that f of 0 is my 0, f dash plus 2 of f is my greater than 0. Oh, very interesting question. Okay, it's just like say differential equation, but the right hand side is not given to you. So very, very simple approach. Simply, you can assume that this value is say h. Fine. So what is the meaning of that? H will be my positive. Fine. Now you can see this is my differential equation. So once this is the differential equation, you can find the auxiliary equation. M plus 2 is 0. So m will be my minus of 2. So complement solution will be c1 e raised to power minus 2x. If I found the particular integral, it will be 1 over d plus 2 times h. So it's a constant. So the only value is my constant. Fine. So the solution of this problem will be c1 e raised to power minus 2x plus h over 2. Now, by using f of x is my 0, 0. So what is my c1? This is a 0. This is a 1. So c1 will be minus h by 2. So what is my solution? H by 2 is a common 1 minus e raised to power minus 2x. So remember, h is my positive. Now look at the options. F of x is a greater than 0 when x is greater than 0. So whenever x is greater than 0, 1 minus e raised to power 2x is always be greater than 0, because this number is a very, very small. Fine. So whenever this number is very, very small and 1 minus 0 is always positive, h is always positive. So this is a greater than 0 whenever x is greater than 0. Whenever x is less than 0, that's the negative. So it means this number will be my less than 0, but h is my positive. So this number is also less than 0 when x is less than 0 is my correct statement. F of x always less than 0 when x is not equal to 0, that's a wrong statement. If you simply take x is my 1, so what is that? It is 1 minus e raised to power minus 2. So clearly says it is my greater than 0. Again, If I simply take x is my minus 1, so this part will be my 1 minus e of 2, which is my less than 0. Again, this option cancel out. And again, you can see again when x is positive, the value of fx is my greater than 0, but he said less than 0. This option also cancel. Okay, look at this again, a gate 2023 statistics. F is given to be, f is my continuous, twice differentiable, which of the following is not true statement. Okay, look at that. Firstly, think about this. F is any continuous function. Can you think any of the continuous function whose second derivative is greater than 0? Oh, very simple, is x squared. Why? Because if you take the second derivative, it will be my 2. Fine. So this satisfied here. G is a decreasing function. What is the meaning of that decreasing is? You have to prove that G dash should be less than 0. So what is the G dash? You can see from here. G dash is nothing but f dash of x minus f dash of 2 minus x. So what is the f dash of this? It's a 2x. What is the f dash of this? It's a 2x. It's a 2 minus x. What is that? It's my 4x minus 4. Now, I can return this as x minus 1. So whenever x lies between 0 and 1, x minus 1 is lies between minus 1 to 0. So it means this number will be my less than 0. So whole number will be my less than 0. So g dash is less than 0 is my correct statement. Look at the C option. Take a function which second derivative is less than 0. I can take it as a minus x square. Fine. G is an increasing function, so g dash must be greater than 0. So again, g dash will be my here. So I can substitute f dash. It is my minus 2x minus minus plus of 2 minus x. So it is 4 minus 4x. So I can return as 4 times 1 minus x. Whenever x lies between 1 and 2, minus of x lies between minus 2 and minus 1. I can add 1 on the both side, it will be 0. So this value will be negative and it will be less than 0, but we need a greater than 0. So this option is cancelled. F double dash 0. What is the meaning of that? Either f is a constant or f is a linear function. Fine. If f is constant, then g is a constant. So f is a constant. So say c, this is c. Again, this is a constant. Fine. If f is a linear function, so I can simply take as a linear is x, then I can substitute here, it is my x, so g will be my x plus 2 minus x, which is again a constant function. So it means this is also the correct statement. Look at the first option. There exists c such that, do you remember any of the result in which derivative will be 0 appears? That's a Rolle's theorem. Fine. What is the property of the Rolle's theorem? You have to prove that g is my continuous on the closed interval of 0, 2, and g is my differentiable on the open interval 0, 2. Then by the Rolle's theorem, there exists at least one c in the open interval such that g dash of c will be 0. So you can see g is a function dependent on the f. I have to prove that g is continuous. So basically I need to prove f is continuous. So but f is already given to you as a continuous. So the first property hold. F double dash. G dash is the derivative of g. And f is a twice differentiable. If f is my twice differentiable, it means g dash is my differentiable. So it means g is my differentiable. So both properties satisfied. This is also the correct statement. But remember, we need a not correct statement. So this is my C is my right answer of this problem. Okay, look at this another one. F is a differentiable function, direction derivative. So whenever there is a differentiable function, you have to use this property. Fine. So function, what is a function? It is not given. So I assume the gradient is my here. Fine. Now, firstly, this is the unit vector. I can take the dot product of this f with the u. This is given to you as a root 5. and del f with respect to v is given to you as root 2. So now I can substitute this value x of this. So this is x plus 2y divided by root 5. I can multiply this by here. Similarly, from this I can multiply this by here. It will be x minus y of 2. Now from these two I can solve it. I can simply subtract them. Y will be my 1, x will be my 3. So gradient is my, so what is the value of this? X is my gradient, fine. So it is 1, it is my 3. So what is the right answer of this problem is 4 is my right answer of this problem. Okay, look at this one. F is, which of the following is there and here? Look at that. Firstly, remember, if my function is given to be here, like, then we all know f is continuous and f is not differentiable at x is equal to 1 and 2. Why? Because we all know mod of x is continuous but not differentiable at x is equal to 0. But here is x minus 1, it means not differentiable at 1 and 2. But if you apply this concept in this case, then you may call as this function is not differentiable at x is 1, y is equal to 2. That means not differentiable at 1 comma 2. But that is your biggest mistake. Why? Why? And you all know this is the kind of, so according to this rule, your correct answer is my here. Fine. But that is your biggest mistake. Why? Because this concept is only applicable when you are working in the R. But here we are working on the R2 plane. R cross R is R2. Then this is not applicable. You can also see this is the XY plane. So then how you can think about this problem? You have to apply the definition of the limits. What is the differentiability? Limit of at the point 1. So 1 plus h, 2 plus k, minus 1 comma 2, minus a times h, b times k, divided by h square plus k square. Fine. Where a is my partial derivative at the point 1 comma 2, b is my partial derivative with respect to y 1 comma 2. So very simple. If you take the partial derivative with respect to x, fine, the function is continuous. Function is continuous throughout. There is no worry because it's a simple here. So if you take the partial derivative with respect to x, it must be of this nature. So whenever y is equal to 2, it is my 0. So this part will be 0. Similarly, b will be 0. No worry. Now you can see what is a 1 plus h. It is mod of h. 2 plus k. It is of k. What is that? It's a 0 divided by h square plus k square. So what is that? The numerator part will be mod of k of this divided by h square plus. Now clearly says the degree of the numerator, degree of this numerator is greater than of the degree of denominator, because the degree of the denominator is my 1. And it is more than 1. So the answer will definitely goes to the 0. So what is the meaning of that? 0 is my finite number and unique. So it means this function is my differentiable. So first option is correct. Second option is wrong. Otherwise, how you can check? We can simply take the path k is equal to mh. So what is that? It's a mod of this. It's mod of this and mod of this. In the numerator side, mod of h is a common. 1 plus m square, so it will be cancelled out. Now sorry this will be cancelled out. This is not cancelled. Now you can take the limit as approaches 0. So because of this part, it's a mod of h, it goes to the 0. Again, it's a unique and fine. So f is a differentiable at 1 comma 2. It also implies f is continuous at the 1 comma 2. He said partial derivative does not exist, but we already proved that the partial derivative exists. Moreover, if f is differentiable, what is the meaning of that? Fx and fy both exist at 1, 2, but he said partial derivative does not exist, so this option is also cancelled out. Remember, if C option is my correct option, then what is the meaning of that? F is not differentiable. Now look at, check about the direction derivative. So what is the direction derivative is? You have to check about the 1, 2. So again, it's, I can simply, I call this is my A, this is my B along the U. So 2 plus HB minus 1, 2. Fine. So what is that? This is the X. If I substitute here, it will be mod of HA. It is mod of HB. This is a 0 divided by H. So one value will be cancelled out. So as, what is the answer of this? As H approaches 0. So because of this H, it goes to the 0. So it means the answer will be 0, but he said 1. So if it is a 1, then there is no need. So your answer will be cancelled. So right answer is only my A is the right answer. There is one more method how you can find the direction derivative. As we prove that it's a differentiable, so we can simply use this value. Fine. So what is that? This is a partial derivative of x with respect to here, x y with respect to this, of this value. But we already see what is the partial derivative of x, f with respect to x. This value is my 0, this value is my 0. So when you multiply them, the answer will be 0. And you can see by either of the way you can get the same answer. So the right answer of this problem is A is the right answer. Okay, the rate of the change, directional derivative. Fine. Now it's a 3-dimensional, so you can find the gradient. So partial derivative with respect to x, 1 plus cos z. Partial derivative with respect to y, minus sin z plus 1. Partial derivative with respect to z, minus x sin z, minus y cos z. Now at which point they want to talk? At the p 0, at the point 2 minus 1 0. What is the gradient? Z is 0, cos 0 is 1, it's a 2. Sin 0 is 0, it's a 1. Sin 0 is 0, cos 0 is 1, and y is equal to minus 1 here. What is the unit vector? So firstly, we can find the value of P0, P1. So it will be 0 minus 2, 1 plus 1, 2 minus here. Fine. So what is the unit vector is? So it is minus 2i cap, 2j cap, 2k cap divided by 4 plus 4 plus 4 is 12. Now, if you take the dot product of F dot U, it is my minus 4 plus 2 plus 2 divided by root 12. So the answer will be 0 is the right answer of this problem. Okay, which of the following again, which is of the form x raised to power a, y raised to power b, x raised to power c, y raised to power d. So what is the a? A is my 2, b is my 1, c is my 2, d is my 2. So what is that? A over C, B over D. Check whether it's a greater than 1 or not. 2 over 2, 1. 1 over 1, it's greater than 1. It means this function is my continuous. Fine. But we are talking about the direction derivative. So I can simply start with this limit h approaches 0. Direction derivative has a 0, 0, all are 0. So it means HA, HB minus 0, 0 divided by h. Fine. So what is that? What is the f of h a h b? So it's a h square h cube a square b divided by h square is a common. It's a square plus b square divide, this is 0 into h. So h cube will be cancelled out. So the right answer of this will be 2 a square b divided by a square plus b. This is the general direction derivative. Now look at the first. If I consider this is a and b, so what is that? It's a 2 into 1 by 2 into 1 by root 2 divided by a square plus b square. It is my 1. So the answer is 1 by root 2, correct option. At the point 0, 1, a is my 0, so b is 1, it is my 0, but he said 1. 1, 0, so 1, 0, 1 plus 0 is a 0, he said 0. F is not differentiable, that is again, because f at the point 0, 0, direction derivative exists. Fine. If a direction derivative exists, then you can say it's a differential. Otherwise you can also check how you can check the differentiability at 0, 0. It is a h, k f of 0, 0. What is the partial derivative? You can see limit h approaches 0, f of h, 0, f of 0, 0 by h. So its answer is 0, 0. So this is 0 h, 0 k divided by root of h square plus k square. So what is that? H of k is here. So 2 h square k divided by h square plus k square into of this. Now clearly says the, how you can say that whether it's a continuous or not, you can simply take the path as h is equal to mk. Fine. Otherwise the degree of this numerator is my 3, above is also 3. Fine. So we can take a simply h is equal to mk. So it will be my m square k cube. It is my h k square plus m square k square, and it will be k is a common, it's a 1 plus m. So you can see what is that? It is a 2 h square k, x square this, and h will be cancelled out. H k square k cube is a cancel out. It's a 2 m square over 1 plus m square. So you can see the limit does not exist. It's not a differentiable. Yes, because the limit does not exist, it means the function is not differentiable. So D is also the right answer. D, C and A. A, C, D are my right answer. Okay, f is a continuous positive real value function from here. Oh, very simple, I think. You can simply take sine of x is my y, then it will be my fy d cos of dy. What is the limit? Sine 0 is 0, sine pi is 0. So what will happen if both the limits are same? Answer is 0. Fine. Okay, look at this another one. A function is given to be here. Okay, first of all, minus of h. Clearly says this is my even function. Fine. Then f of h is nothing but f of minus h. Fine. So the numerator part will be double. So it's a 2 times 3 h square plus 4 of cos h minus 8 over h square. Now if I open this bracket, it will be 6 h square plus 8 is a common, cos h minus 1 over h square. If I separate them, it's a 6 plus 8 over h square. What is the cos x minus 1? It is a minus 2 sine square h. Fine. Now how h square by 2. Now I can simply multiply by h square by 4 and h square by 4. Fine. This value goes to the 1 as h approaches 0. H square will be cancelled out. 4 is a 2. So 6 minus 4. The right answer of this problem is my 2 is the right answer of this problem. Okay, look at this. Now remember, this function is my here. You can't apply this rule like x raised to power a, y raised to power b, x raised to power c, x raised to power d. This rule, as I mentioned you, whenever a, b, c, d all are my greater than 0. But you can see this value is my 0. It is not satisfied this property. Fine. So again, a very simple, whether the partial exists or not. Firstly, check whether it's a continuous or not. You can write in the polar form. Very simple. Then denominator will be r square. Numerator will be r cube cos cube. It will be r cos cube. So what will happen if I take the limit r approaches 0? Is it a finite answer? It goes to the 0. It's a finite. Fine. It means this function is my continuous. Clear? Now partial derivative. Very simple. You can start with the limit h approaches 0, f of h, 0, f of 0, 0. So what is the numerator part? H, 0. This value will be 0. It's a h minus 0 over h. is a 1. So first answer is cancel. What is the partial derivative with respect to y? Limit h approaches 0. So this is a 0 comma h. So it's a 0 comma h is a 0 minus 0 over 0. So both are existence. Both are exist and are equal. Cancel. Fine. How you can check whether they are differentiable or not? We can check at the point 0 comma 0. Hk f of 0 comma 0. This is my a. This is my b. A is my 1. B is my 0. Divided by here. Fine. Now I can write this here. Hk. So h cube h square plus k square. This is 0 minus h divided by root of this. So if I take the LCM, h square will be cancelled out. The final is h k square divided by h square plus k square of 3 over 2. Fine. Now what is that? If I simply take, the path is k is equal to mh. The numerator part will be minus h m square h square. Denominator part h square will be common. So ultimately h cube divided by 1 plus m square of 3 by 2. So you can see it is dependent on the m. So limit is not unique. It means this is not differential. So this option will also cancel. Only the right answer is my here. Otherwise you can also check the direction derivative. At the point 0, 0 is ha, hb. F 0, 0 is a 0 here over h. You can substitute here. It is a h cube, a cube. H square is a common. A square plus b square. So divided by h. So it will cancel out. So the answer is a cube. So it is a existence. So it means the directional derivative exists along any direction. So it is also existence in the straight line direction. So the right answer is C. Okay, look at this another one which is given to be here. Again, they are talking about the partial derivative, continuous, differentiable, and here. We can easily write in the polar form. Fine. So what will happen in the polar form is, it is my r square. It is sine of 1 by r square. So what will happen if you take the limit as r approach, this is the bounded function, so it goes to the 0. It means the function is continuous. Fine. So look at the option, function is not continuous. Third is cancel. So third is cancel. Fine. Now 1, 2, 3, 4. Check whether the partial derivative exists or not. How you can check whether the partial derivative exists or not? You can fx. Fine. So limit h approaches 0, f of h comma 0, and 0, 0 is a 0 divided by h. So what is h comma 0? Y is a 0. Y is a 0 is a h square. So it is my h square sine of 1 by h square divided by h. So again it goes to the 0. What is the fy? So it is again limit h approaches 0. This is my 0 comma h. So 0 comma h is again my h sine of 1 by h square. Again it goes to the 0. It means both the partial derivative exist and are unbounded. How you can prove that it's unbounded? What is the property of the unbounded is? You can simply take limit of this as your xy in the neighborhood of 0, 0. If it goes to infinity, then we can say it is unbounded. Fine. Now clearly say, what is my fx? As I found this, this is the h sine of 1 by h square. Fine. So whenever as x comma y approaches 0 comma 0. Fine. So what is the meaning of that? This limit of the 1 by h square is my infinite. Fine. This is the oscillating sequence. So it means this is the unbounded. Similarly, fy is also infinity. So it is the unbounded. So what is the meaning of that? It means the first is my correct statement. Whether it's a differentiable or not. Now the only thing you need to check whether it's a differentiable or not. So how you can check about the differentiability? Again the same rule. We can start with the h comma k 0 comma 0 minus a. What is the partial derivative limit? I computed as a 0. B is also 0. So divided by h square plus k square. Fine, if I substitute this value here, it will be h square k square, and it will be h square k square. I can written as h square plus k square of sine 1 over h square plus k square. Now, what is the limit of this? As again, you can change into the polar coordinate if you want. So it will be my r sine of 1 by r, and it goes to the 0 as r goes to the 0. Otherwise, you can simply goes to the 0 as h comma k goes to the 0 comma 0. So what is the meaning of that? The function is differentiable. The function is differentiable, correct? But it's not differentiable is the wrong option. So first and fourth are my correct options. So the B is my correct answer. Okay, this is I already told you, because the function is continuous, you can simply take any of the path. So along this path, x is a 0. So substitute x is 0 here. It is a 9y square divided by 9y square plus 64. It must be same as of C. Now what is happen? If you take y, you can rationalize them. It will be simply of this nature. Fine. So what is happen? Y is equal to 0. It's a 8 plus 8. The function is continuous only when x is, C is my 60. Okay, look at this another one. Again, function is given to be here. Function is continuous or not. You can simply convert into the polar form. Fine. Denominator is my r is to power 4. Numerator is r square is a common. It's a cos square minus sin square. Fine. So what will happen if I simply take this? So it will be the above part is cos of 2 theta divided by r square. What will happen if I take the limit as r approaches 0? It is here. So what is the meaning of that? The function is not continuous. If it is not continuous, it means it is not differentiable. So first option is cancel. Now, if the function is not differentiable, what is the meaning of that? Either this or this does not exist. Fine. So both the derivative exist, but we all know that if the function is not differentiable, it means either fx or fy does not exist. He said both exist. So this option is also cancelled. Now you have to integrate of the modulus value. So let me clear this screen. So I can start with any one of them. So say double integration of mod xy. So it is a x square minus y square over x square plus y square of dx dy, minus 1 to 1, minus 1 to 1. How you can integrate is sometimes it's a difficult. So what you can do, you can change the polar coordinates. So this value will be cos 2 theta divided by r square into dx is a dr d theta. Fine. Now you can take the limits. Firstly, what is the value of the limit is minus 1 to 1. And complete is my here. So what is that? It is here. Now limits are my constant. So you can integrate 1 by r cos of 2 theta dr d theta minus 1 to 1, 0 to 2 pi. So what is our limit of here? This is 1 to minus 1. Fine. But clearly see that this is does not exist, because log 1 minus log of minus 1. This value is undefined. This value is 0, fine. But this value is undefined. It means this integration is not a finite. But he said it's a finite. This option is cancelled. Left option is only C is the right answer of this problem. Okay, look at this last question here. Again, you can see this is of the form x raised to power a, y raised to power b, x raised to power c, y raised to power d. Here a is my 2, b is my 1, c is 2, d is my 2. So what is that? A over c plus b over d. Is it greater than 1? 2 over 2 plus 1 over 2 is greater than 1. It means this function is my continuous. Fine. But they are talking about whether it's bounded or not. Very simple. Very, very simple. I will tell you the two different methods. How you can check for the bounded? You can start with the modulus sign. You can check for here. Fine. Now I can return this number as mod of y, and this is x square over x square plus y square. This number is always less than 1. Fine. So it means this number is less than or equal to 1. So this number is like here. But what is the y? The domain of the y is r cross r, and this r. So it means this is my unbounded. Fine. So what is the meaning of that? F is my unbounded. Clear? So both f and bounded cancel. F is bounded, cancel. Now, how you can prove that whether the partial derivative with respect to x is a bounded or not? You can find the partial derivative with respect to x. It will be y times of x square over x. It will be y times x square over x square plus y square. Fine. So it will be 2x over x square plus y square minus of 2x cube over x square plus y square. Otherwise, there is no need. We have to simply find the values at. I can clear this screen as well. Is there any point is given to you? No, it is bounded on R2. So I can apply this definition. Limit h comma 0 f of a plus h comma b f of a comma b. Fine, at any point. So now we can f of a plus h square of b divided by a plus h square. Otherwise, we already solved this simple problem xy. So over x square plus y square is a common. So x square plus y square minus of 2x square divided by here. So what is that? It is xy, x square minus y square, minus is a common, divided by of this value. Fine. Now, how you can prove whether it's a bounded or not? So you can see function is a continuous, partial derivative of here. So this number, okay, so you can see xy over this and x square minus y over this. So this number is also less than 1, always. This number is also less than 1. If I take the modulus value, so this number is definitely here. Product is also less than 1. So it means this partial derivative is my bounded. So it's unbounded, cancel. So only right option is my left, is the B is the right answer of this problem. So this is the way you can solve its question in a very, very simple manner. Remember the shortcut tricks that you learn from here, you can apply in your other sphere. We will see the next lecture on the testing of the hypothesis. Again, from this, you can simply scan and join my WhatsApp group. I hope you can like and share my videos. Best of luck, students. Happy learning.